Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. In Vue.js, entire page is divided into small pieces of components and each component has its own functionality and UI. In the component-based architecture, we may need to share data between the components. So today in this video, we're going to learn how to achieve communication between different components. In Vue.js, three most common ways to share data between components are 1. From parent component to child component. For that, we use props that we have learned in the third part of this Vue.js component series. If you have not watched that video, I highly recommend you to watch that first. I will put the link of it in the video description. In the props, we pass custom attribute to the child component to pass data from parent component to child component. For example, here we have this app parent component and here we have created this message child component. Here we have passed the custom attribute to share a message, this. And in the message component, it is accepting that prop. And here we have printed that message. And in the browser, it will print right here. Now how we can pass data from the child component to this parent component. For that, we use custom events. Let's see example of it. Let's say here we have data property. And it has count. And I will print that count here. To tag and in the browser here the zero is printed. Next I will create a counter button component. I'll say counter button dot view. Here I'll add a template and script. In this template we have button type button and increment. Now let's import that counter button here. And we're gonna register that component here. Now we can use that right here. Let's see this in browser. Here we get the increment button. Now what we want, on click this button, we're gonna increment this count. So for that, we'll say at click, we're gonna run this increment method. Now let's create this method. So we'll add methods property, increment method. Now how are we gonna pass increment data from this component to here? For that here I'll create custom event. So here I'll say this dot dollar emit. Next here we'll pass the event name. Let's say increment. Next here we'll pass the data. Let's say I want to increment it by 1. So here I'll pass 1. Our next step is to listen that event in this app component. For that here I'll say p-on then event name, or we can use shorthand at an event name. Next, and on increment here I'll run method increment count. Now let's create that method here, methods property. Here it will accept the data and we'll say this dot count plus equal to data. Let's see this in browser, increment, and here it is incrementing by 1. If we change increment by 2, refresh. Now it is incrementing by 2. Now here what we are doing, here we have this count data and we have printed right here. Next, here we created this counter button component, and in this counter button component we have button, and on click that counter button we have emitted this increment event. Now to listen this event, here we said at increment and we call this method, and in this method we incremented count by this data, which is that we passed here. Next we're gonna see event bus. The event bus is not limited to parent child relationship. Using event bus we can share information in any component. Let's see example of it. So let's clear this. Now here I'll create a new component, tasklist.view. It has template, script, and it has data. Tasks. Task 1. Task 2. And task 3. Just print that here. Div ul li v hyphen 4 task in tasks. Here we get this error, that is because we need to bind here key to fix this. So I'll say task, and I'll also fetch index, and I'll pass that index here. Now the error is fixed. And b text task. Next I'm gonna import that task here. So I'll say import components task list. And register that task here. Let's print that here. I'll say task list. Now let's see this in browser. It printed the old task. A little bit formatting. Let's add here heading also. And here I'll add style display flex justify content center. Now it looks much better. Next I'll create task input component. So task input dot view, we'll say template and script. Here I'll add input type text v hyphen model is equal to task. Next here I'll add data property, so return task. Initially it is empty. Now let's import that here. Task input. Register that here. Now here task input component. It is in browser, and here we have this input right here. Now what here I want, when I enter a task here and it should be received in this component, and we will push that task in this task list. So for that here we use event bus. So first here say that key press and key press dot enter. On enter in this input field I'll call add new task method. Let's register that method now. So here I'll add method property, add new task. Now to share from this task input component to this task list component, we use event path. So here I'll say this dot dollar root dot dollar emit, and then we say the event name, let's say new task, and then the data this dot task, and after that we'll say this dot task is empty. Now to listen this event right here in this task list component, here we'll add new property created, and here we'll say this dot dollar root dot on the event name, that is this new task, and then we're gonna pass a function. Here I'll use arrow function. It will accept the task. Next we will push this task in the task list, so we say this dot task dot push task. This is all we need here. Now let's see this in browser, task 4, and it is included right here. Task 5, it is listed here. So let's review this. Here we created two components, task lists and task input. Here we listed this task lists here and task input here. Now here our goal is to share data from this component to this component. So in the task input component, when we enter the task, here we fire this add new task, and in this task we use the event bus, so we emitted this new task event. And in the task list component, here we listen this task and post right here. This is all in this video. If you like the video, hit the like button, share this video, and don't forget to subscribe us. See you in the next lesson.